Hello everyone, I am Raman Pahuja. So firstly, let me know, have you subscribed my channel? If no, then please subscribe as soon as possible and press the bell icon so that you can get notification of my every update. So today our topic is capacity, and in this video I'll tell you about what is capacity, types of capacities and difference between efficiency and utilization, bottleneck operation, effects of that bottleneck, and how to reduce or eliminate those effects. So let's start with the capacity. So do you know what is capacity? Okay, I'm giving you just 30 seconds to think about that. So your time starts now. No, not only one definition, you can think about two or three more and more. So think about that, you have just 13 seconds. Only five. Okay, time's up. So now I'll explain what is capacity. The capacity has so much definitions. As you can say, the maximum limit of the load that any operating unit can handle is called the capacity, or the maximum work that can be done by any machine or man is called capacity. And the further slides I'll explain you more and more about this capacity in the types of capacity. So the main thing is to remember is capacity is always inversely proportional to our load. If our load is increasing, it means the capacity is decreasing. So how we can manage this? We have to use the skilled manpower, and the quantity of manpower should be enough. And the second thing is type of equipment. Our machine should be upgraded, and the third one is standardized process. If we need to get the actual output, if we need to get the maximum output from our process, then firstly we have to standardize our process, because without standardization we cannot get the maximum output. So remember this point, the load is always inversely proportional to our capacity, and to increase the capacity we need to get 3 points: the skilled manpower, types of equipment, and the third one is standardized process. So let's have the types of capacity. There are two types of capacities. The first one is designed capacity and the second is effective capacity. So the design capacity, an operating unit or any machine that is designed for, okay, designed for how much maximum output is called the design capacity. And the effective capacity, if we are just reducing the personal time and give some allowances to that, after that how much output we are getting, that is called our effective capacity. And the actual output, you already know how much actually output we are getting, it's called our actual output. That is, I am just telling you because in the next slide I'll explain you about the difference between efficiency and utilization. So that's why remember this: design capacity, efficient effective capacity, and actual output, because these three things will use in efficiency and utilization. For example, we are having just 24 hours in a day. Okay, so that is the design capacity of our day, and we are having 6 hours mandatory for rest. For an example, we are having 6 hours mandatory for our rest. It means we are having just 18 hours. So these 18 hours is our effective capacity. And if actually we are working only 15 hours, it means that is our actual output. Got it? So now efficiency and utilization. As in previous slide, I told you the design capacity is 24 hours in a day, and the effective capacity is 18 hours, and the actual output is 15 hours. So the difference between efficiency and utilization is The efficiency is depends upon our effective capacity, and the utilization is depends upon our designed capacity. Because in efficiency, we are just calculating how efficiently we are utilizing our machine or our time or man. And in utilization, we are just calculating how much time we have utilized. So in efficiency, for example, 15 hours we have actually working for 15 hours, and our effective capacity is 18 hours. So it means we have used 83.3% efficiently our day. And if we are talking about utilization, we have just utilized our day 62.5%. So that is the major difference between efficiency and utilization. Now, bottleneck operation. As you can see, we are having one bottle, okay, with the proper neck. So the flow of the water, this bottle will be very less. But if we are having another bottle and we are just cutting the neck of that bottle, for that the flow of the water will be too much. It means, what is the bottleneck operation? That operation which is just reducing the flow of our material. As in the bottles, neck of that bottle is reducing the flow of water. Same in that case, if our any machine is reducing the flow of our material, it means that is our bottleneck operation. Or we can say an operation which has maximum cycle time, it's called an bottleneck operation. For example, we are having one machine cycle time with 10 seconds. Another machine is having 5 seconds. Third machine 18 seconds, and the fourth one is 11 seconds. So the third one is 18 seconds is our bottleneck operation, because this machine is just reducing our flow of that material. The fourth machine always will wait for 7 seconds in every cycle. So that is the bottleneck operation. That effects of bottleneck operations. First one, less output. If one of the machine having too much cycle time, for sure the next machine will wait for that. Okay, so then the output will be reduced. The second thing, waiting loss. Either the man or machine or the both, they will wait for the part. And the third one is less efficiency. Efficiency input upon output. So the efficiency will be less. For example, the first machine is having cycle time of 12 seconds and the second one is 11 seconds. So the next machine, the second machine, will wait for 1 second in every cycle, and having third machine with 9 seconds, so it will wait for 2 seconds in a cycle. Then the next machine is having 8 seconds, it means it will wait for 1 second in every cycle. The next machine is having cycle time of 20 seconds. It means it will wait for 12 seconds in every cycle. So the output will depends upon the last machine, because it is having the maximum cycle time 20 seconds. So the output will be only 3 parts per minute. Right. Because is depending upon the last machine, our bottleneck operation, the 20 seconds. According to 20 seconds, only 3 parts per minute will be our output. So how we can reduce or eliminate those effects? The first one, if we need to get the maximum output, if we are only talking about the maximum output, just reduce the bottleneck operation time. Only need to reduce the bottleneck operation time. For an example, we are having last machine cycle time is 20 seconds, but if we will reduce it by 8 seconds, the cycle time will be 12 seconds, and the automatically the output will be increased by 2 parts per minute. According to 12 seconds, we will get 5 parts per minute. So the first effect that has been reduced by just doing one thing, just reducing the bottleneck operation time. How to reduce the waiting loss of man or machine and the less efficiency? It can be done by just line balancing. Even in my further videos, I will explain deeply about the line balancing, but in this we are having just a small example of that. In this, we will queue just one manpower to third and fourth machine. In the previously, we were using five manpower for five machines. In this, man and machine both were waiting. So the waiting loss were high and our efficiency was also less because our input was maximum. Our input was five members, five manpower, and our output was only three parts per minute. But in this, if we will give just one manpower to third and fourth machine, it means our waiting loss will be reduced. The manpower will not wait, only machine will wait. In the third machine will wait only 2 seconds and the fourth one is only for 1 second. But we have reduced just our input. It means we are using four manpower for three parts per minute. And we can do both of the things at the same time. As we can just reduce the bottleneck operation time as well as reduce the manpower. In this, all the three effects will be reduced and our output will be high, waiting loss will be less, and the efficiency will be increased. So thanks a lot for watching till the end. Please like, share video, and my forthcoming videos will be depends upon your requirement. What's your requirement? Just comment on that video. And remember one thing, this is just the basic of capacity. So these all terms we will use in the capacity planning. So thanks a lot for watching.